I'm here to talk a little bit about my own experience and how we go about helping people. And I'd want to clarify first that the digital navigator job acts as some kind of complement to what we understand as a general customer service over the phone that we're so used to. I'd like to point out how our patrons usually are very resolved people. They go out of their way. They go seek for help first. They will come to us with stories about having received help from various customer service representatives from different companies and such. But there's not really a learning process unless there's someone behind helping through all of these moving pieces. It's more of a learning frustration that happens a lot of the time. It's a full job in all of its in the full sense of that word. It takes a lot of bandwidth to deal with patrons. There are lots of different cases. We have people that will be hard to contact. A lot of times the people that are most in need are not necessarily the ones that speak out the most and talk and demand help, and they're not necessarily the most outspoken about it. And then we also have people that will come weekly, will come frequently to get that help. So that entire gap is one that we fill as digital navigators. And I'd like to also point out some tips for any organizations out there that might wanna start putting of a project like this. And I'd like to remind the basic principles that we've been going over here, which is to have a lot of empathy in your heart to help people, to do it unconditionally, and start from a place of love and understanding. There's not just a class divide that makes people come to situations where they struggle with technology, situations of illiteracy. There's also a generational divide that brings all those same consequences. For me, as a relatively young person, helping other older patrons figure out how to keep up with the pace of technology has been very humbling. It's a really necessary job to do this, and it takes resources. I'm here to advocate for more devices for people, and more people ready to help. This is the classic job of a social worker, and it's really necessary. There's resources, physical resources, material conditions that need to be fulfilled on the side of actual internet access and access to devices. But there's also the training that Paula was pointing out. And I'd like to thank my city library, Salt Lake City Library, that employs me, that has been really, really pushing me to learn more about emotional intelligence and all the other skills that promote a good mental health to be behind these efforts, these helpful efforts to our patrons. It's very important to note those two kinds of resources, both material and immaterial, in terms of training. And I have met wonderful people. I'm working with other great digital navigators in other organizations, and it's been really, really, really useful, really bonding to get to know everyone's experience and see how we all help in order to come to a good synthesis of how to go about helping our communities in the best way.
Yeah.